anytime I can fish a brand new lake or a brand new adventure, I'm in. Because isn't that what life's all about? New adventures, new spots, first thing in the morning, sun rising, boats going out, my heart's beating, and seeing that and feeling a nice, big, beautiful smallmouth bass. Oh boy. Good smallmouth. Oh, look how fast he's coming at me. Look at that. Talk about a beast, eh? The beast from the east. Wow, are you guys ever tough. First morning. 10th cast. Look at him go. Look at that. These are tough smallmouth here, dude. Tough. But that's why I came for fun. Such a risk with topwater, but boy, is that ever fun. Oh yes. You guys are a blast here, boy. You guys are a blast. So close I can get you if I can put you safely in the net. Whoa, get away from those rods. Look how tough these bass are. And there's the first one of our trip. Oh, look at that, and the popper just came off. Well, there's our start right there at Camp Conowongo near North Bay. A few fat picture fish. Look at that, like a little football. Aren't you gorgeous? There's Ontario's finest right there. Just a nice, solid, fat bass. Let's regroup and let's continue, and I'll show you the whole deal as I continue this beautiful extreme angler adventure. So, brand new lodge. You know we got smallmouth. It's got big muskie, pike, largemouth. Very reputable for walleyes and stuff here too. That's what's in Ontario's backyard, man. Opportunities like this, you gotta get out, explore. Especially for our US friends watching. I mean, this place, you gotta consider it. All my buddies who do fish these areas called me when they knew I was coming here and said, Carl, the walleyes are in the same area as the largemouth, that deeper weed. The lake's got tons of it. It's got tons of natural points and rocks and boulders and stuff. And you know I love throwing the smallmouth on top. So coming to a lake like this, you know I'm gonna have topwater walking baits, popping baits. Today is smallmouth day. Hey. Ain't as big as your buddy, but oh, he's barely got it too. Oh, he might be one of those ones you see and then gone. Look. What do I care? I'm having fun. Look. What do I care? You want to come to Ontario? This is the deal right there, dude. Look at that. We've got millions of these right here. Smallmouth bass just waiting for you, boys and girls. Look at. Oh, there's the cabbage right there. I need to mark this spot, too. Oh, that's okay, buddy. I'm going to let you go in about 2 seconds. Ready? Right there. So what I do, too, is get on my sonar and mark it. Symbol. I'm going to mark the weed. That's what I'm going to mark. Christmas tree right there. Go back. Now it's marked. So two fish by the big boulder. Seen cabbage. Got one about 3. Another one about 1.75 pounds. This is it right here. Let's continue. Not far. This cabbage patch is right here. Ooh, it's big. How big are you? Ooh, nice fish. Look at that. Oh yeah. Ooh. Look at you. Wow, he doesn't want to fight. Look, look. Wow, there's the shortest fight of a smallmouth in my life right there. The shortest fight. Look at that. He's got a scar on him. Look how long these fish are. Really, look at them. Look how long. Dark. Sitting by those rocks and weeds. And take a picture of a couple of you fish, huh? Yeah, I'll show you people at home. But look at. That's Ontario's finest right there. Smallmouth bass. Right here. Talon Lake. Whew. Fun fish. Perfect size for topwater fishing right there, man. We'll continue along this edge. I'm out in 7 feet of water, almost in the middle of the lake. And behind me was 100 feet came up. And that's the big thing for having forage baits for a good population of all the species I just mentioned. So we'll keep continuing, and hopefully my little Yuzuri prism popper gets me. Point coming out, surrounded by boulders and stumps and stuff, tapers down, big, beautiful basketball sized boulders is the best way to describe it. And it tapers down fast. The water's got, it's not tea color, it's not clear. So it's almost that perfect look. And it's got cabbage weed, it's got pencil weed. That cabbage weed, when you find it in Ontario, muskies love it, smallmouth love it, walleyes sometimes. But I found that anytime you find that cabbage, get ready for either a big ski or a nice brownie. Hey, I think I'll just keep fishing. Look at him. Man, these bass are wild here. Look at them, wild. Wow, lots of fun, man. This is fun. Maybe 2-pounder. I'll let him scrap. Look how they go round and round. I think they're gonna get off, eh? He might come off when I lift him up. Let's see. Oh, Karl. Whoa. Hold on, buddy. I'm just gonna shake you off, okay? I ain't gonna touch you. That's why I bring them pliers in the boat. But these bass are fat. See ya. Okay, see this point right here? It's only 6 feet of water. And probably spawning all gravel and rocks and stuff like that. But when it tapers down like this, only 6 feet, what I'll do is angle my boat instead of going all the way around and try and look for more deep water and stuff. Knowing that this point goes out, there's boulders and stuff, I'll fish out here where it tapers out. Those fish won't go far from where they spawned. Smallmouth are notorious for hanging around their areas where they spawned. So I'll fish this point, zigzag it, and then I'll move on. Looking for the ones that maybe are cruising those edges. 8, 9, 10, depending how fast it drops off or how far it tapers out. They can be out in 20 feet of water. This lake has a lot of deep water forage, smelt. I don't know if there's alewife or herring and stuff, but it's got lake trout, and I know it got smelt, so there's a good chance some of these big smallmouth could be just staging up that deep stuff. Oof. Decent, eh? Oh, he's barely hooked. Barely hooked. This could be crucial. Right off that point. And I see cabbage there already. Decent little bass. Look at the belly on these fish. Hey, look how long. Isn't that nice? Tell me he's not eating, eh? Wow. Give him for some pictures and then we'll let him go. When you find weeds, sometimes it just takes an hour or two to figure out stuff real quick. And we've done that here on this lake. Found cabbage, points, yes, with rock. I mean, I bet you there's walleyes. I seen a muskie earlier too, but it seemed like these smallmouth love that topwater bite. And I'm catching them all in the popper. I think I knew what that was. Decent little smallmouth. Chased it all out from those little pad bed there. Isn't that something? Wow. Decent little guy. You grabbed it on top too, not wild. Like he swam at it, like a shark from those pads. Just decent fish. Oh, he's better than I thought. Look at you, hey? You ain't too bad at all, hey? Oh, you got some thickness to you. Wow, look at the girth on these fish. What do you think they're eating? Crayfish, mayflies, perch, or a combination of all the others and the rest. Look at that, just a decent fish, boy. On the Yuzuri popper, ready? Go on, go on. Wow, zigzagging around. Those little pads right there. And I see some grass inside there. That's all it was, a little patch. All rock here, nothing, deep water, find some cabbage, there's the bass. They want the benefits of lodge life. It ain't just the fishing, catching all kinds of fish, having a great time, having naps, great scenery, great serenity, wilderness. It's about the meals, pops with the friends. And we're having it right now, so should you. We'll see you after the break. I was fishing out there, I seen the cloud cover come in, so I saw weeds and stuff. And that's the thing about fishing new lakes. Scout them, you know, take half a day, hire a guide, talk to the lodge owner, different people at the lodge that know the lake. Just, you know, shortens your learning capacity for trying to find out where the hazards are, if there's any rock shoals, points, sunken islands and things like that. But for me, I just want to see, okay, I know what I want to fish, but then I break it down and find the things that I like isolated patchy weed, see if the fish feed really shallow in 3.5 feet of water. Whoa! See how far my bait was over there? I come to another point. Get a fish on the backup bait. Man, he grabbed that Ned rig fast. What a lake. What a lake. They're really footballs here. Football-sized bass. Oh, there's another one with them too. Oh boy. He's got friends. They almost look like largemouth, this lake, because they're so green. Get away from there. I know you're tough. Come here. Oh yeah. Another good way to start, huh? Got one out there. Missed one out there. Pound and a half, pound plus. Who cares? But 1-2 punch, huh? Had that little impact bait, mini craw. Work in different spots. Out in the main lake channel. We've got a little cloud cover now, but doesn't matter. These fish want to eat. We're going to keep going, catch some more. That one feels a bit better. Look how much water is moving. Oh, oh yeah. Wow. Just a nice fish. Boy, he moved some good water. Tell me that's not fun, eh? Oh, he's dark too. Wow. Need a little drag? A little? All right. Just in case you do a power surge. Oh, you're better than I thought. 2+. Look at him. Spitting water at you. Wow. What a fishery. A lot of bass here, man. You want to come in? Hey. Oh, man. Whoa, whoa, look at their bellies. Oh, hold on. Look at the bellies on these fish, man. Look at that. Wow. Are you ever on the feed bag, eh? Oof. Ever on the feed bag. Let's let them go. Look at that. Gorgeous smallmouth. You think we're spoiled in Ontario? We are, man. Let's keep going. Let's see if there's any more along here, eh? Let's see. Just, let's see. Wow, we are spoiled. So much opportunity, so many bass, lakes. Look, no one's around, just me. It's a public lake. Come on, show me another one there. See, he was up tight. I'm in 6 feet of water, tapers down. Now, lots of options. You could fish jerkbait first thing. Crankbait's another really good way to find bass fast. But I just like the topwater because that surface commotion really targets them and really calls them in. This is all about finding fish fast. That's all you want to do. Find them fast, because you know at first light, it's just sun's just coming up, those fish are going to be aggressive, especially those smallmouth. At nighttime prowl, schools of them going around, all of a sudden, boom, out they go. So find them fast. The topwater, my option. Whoa, lordy me. I was about to twitch it. Looks like a decent fish too. I was about to just twitch it, and there he was.
Oh, you are a good one too.
Wow. So deceiving, huh? Look at him. Wow. So deceiving. Oh, wow. Whoa, look at you. That's one of those good ones, eh? Whew, look at you. Boy, you are deceiving. I was just about to twitch my bait, and I guess I got lucky and twitched it right when you decide to want to eat it, huh? Look at him. He's got a torn mouth. God, look at that. Is that a river fish or what, eh? This is part of that Mattawa River. Look how long that is. Ooh, I'm glad you didn't jump and come off. I'd say you're 8 pounds, right? You are warm. Look at that. There's one of Ontario's finest. Think about that, man. Ontario is where it's at. Let's put her and let her swim for a bit. We'll take some pictures. And yeah, for sure, we will let these fish go. But look at that, man. Look at the length of that. She's pushing some serious length. The breeze came up a little bit. I thought, you know what? I'll go back to that shallow stuff and take a look, because I saw some real nice weeds in there. Right away, there was fish feeding everywhere, all over the place. But the size wasn't what I wanted. I came out to that main lake out from the lodge, down to 100 and something feet. When you find that deep water, big fish love to be near deep water. Forage, security, weather changes, you name it. Not gonna get scientific, but it's truth. You find a flat like this, big, huge flat with grass near deep water, fish it, man, fish it every single day.
So my name's Chris Winterburn. This is my wife, Wendy Morley. We're the owners of Camp Conowango. We're a four-season resort located on the beautiful shores of Lake Talon. As soon as fishing season's open, we welcome anglers of all type. This lake, you're spoiled for choice. There is tons of, lots of bass, lots of lake trout, muskie, pike, pickerel, yeah, whatever you're into, we can definitely set you up. We have a campground, 71 sites, 10 of which are overnight. Bring your own trailer. We also have cottages, so we can set you up that way as well. The other beach is in our main campground. It's about 200 feet of very, very nice sand. Nice shallow entry, beautiful for family, beautiful for kids. We do have a full service restaurant. It's fully licensed. Come on in, have a drink. We'll make dinner for you. We do meal plans for guys that don't want to cook for themselves or self-cater, but you're certainly more than welcome to bring your own stuff. All of our cottages have full kitchens. And I'm sure if you come out, give us a try, not only the lake, but the resort itself, you'll learn to love it just as much as we do, and you'll be back time and time again.
That was 9 feet. Up to 7, 2 casts, twitch, but I already saw fish and I saw bait fish. So if the topwater can't bring them up, I will resort to the plastics, because if they're on that edge, but there's always going to be some first thing in the morning that want to eat on top. So come around, stay on the trolling motor, believe in your electronics, find those fish that want to feed. Oh, another black one. Wow. Soft bite. Oh, you're a good one too, eh? Look at you. Wow. Man, nothing wrong with you. Look at that. Wow. Oh yeah, wow. What fun, man. What fun. Whew, you do got some thickness to you, hey? I gotta get my net wet again, look at that. Come on, cheek out of the net. There, you did that, look at that, eh? Look at that, she shook out of there. Look at that, hey? 2+, we're gonna call it. We're gonna put 2 fish in the box and just keep calling out, calling in, calling out, okay? 2 fish in the box, join your big, This one is like a football. Look how much they're so thick, scrappy, man. I love smallmouth bass, man. Wow. Go around. See, this flat is good. But where I caught fish, I marked on my sonar. So it all looks sort of the same. 2.5, 3, 4 feet deep. But certain areas definitely have the bait fish. Where the bait fish are, the bass are. Man, what an amazing fishery and location for you this summer. Shallow, sandy beaches for the families and excellent angling opportunities for a wide range of species. Book your vacation to Camp Conowongo on Talon Lake by calling 1-866-802-6644 or visit them online. Thanks for watching.